Our team coverage continues right now. Let's get straight to Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Christian Colon. He's live in West Haven with reports of a possible landslide near the train tracks, and he's interviewing a senator. Christian.
Hi there, Wendell. Yeah, good morning. Yeah, there's reports of a landslide right behind us, and joining us to talk a little bit more about what's going on is Senator Richard Blumenthal. Senator, thank you so much for joining us this morning. What exactly is going on behind us?
This bank is totally compromised, so the trains are no longer able to use it. What they're trying to do is inspect, determine what has to be done. I've been in touch with the Metro North leadership, trying to get them immediately to take some short-term action so Metro North can continue to run. But long-term, we need to recognize resiliency, coastal investment, infrastructure, picture's worth a thousand words, and people ought to be convinced that we need to invest.
This right here. I know Public Works Director mentioned about, I mean, they don't want to move forward cleaning up the debris until MTA kind of steps in. I mean, what is next?
What's next is to ensure that Metro North can continue to serve the people of Connecticut to get to work, to get to visit families. But longer term, there has to be investment in these tracks, the strength of the support material, the beams, and all of the structure has to be reinforced. And that's a major construction project that has to be done up and down the tracks of Metro North. Investment, straightening the tracks so we can have high-speed rail. Safety and reliability have to be job number one.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning. So we'll continue to bring you the very latest on this landslide and what happens next. I know MTA just arrives on scene and there are some trains still going. Again, we'll bring you the very latest coming up at 12 and on our later newscast. For now, we're live in West Haven. Christian Colon, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.